Okay guys, let's start. Time. So, my name is András Primár, and I work with Olapora, and my talk will be about several screen support case studies. I will discuss only one big case study and another small examples about from the past year. So probably you all know what Olapora is. Olapora is an open source company. Olapora Productivity is a subsidiary of Olapora, who do consultancy around LibreOffice. Who are the main developers of LibreOffice Online, Olapora Online, as you like. But from our point of view, the most important thing that we are dedicated to enterprise LibreOffice. We have a product called Olapora Office, and we provide diversity support for Olapora Office. So let's define the terms, what we mean by diversity support. So for my point of view, level 1 support is some basic support and troubleshooting. So for example, the user cannot print and the helpdesk ask her to switch on the paper or something like that. So the very basic level. To support is the over user level and some configuration, need some configuration, some registry hacking or I don't know. The problem can be solved. So these tasks are usually outsourced to our partners or to our customers who can deal with the users the native language, and usually we don't take those support requests. Of course, there are exceptions. But the most important thing that we are doing is the level 3 support, and the resolution of the issue requires change at the source code level. And it also requires, if you change the source code, of course, we have to create a build. We cannot wait for 6 months to appear the fix in the upstream LibreOffice. So we create a build, we call this program temporary fix build, and we provide the user with the fix right away. So the usual diversity support action lifecycle is that we, depending on the service level agreement that we have with the customer, we confirm the problem and evaluate the problem. Usually it happens within a day, business day, let's say. And then we start to fix the issue right away, which may take a few days or sometimes a few weeks. It depends on the complexity of the problem. And then we provide a BTF build. So we, of course, push the things upstream to get it. Immediately to master branch LibreOffice usually, and it will appear in the next LibreOffice release we have run, but it will take time, so it could take up to 6 months. On the other hand, in all of our office release, which we release it on a monthly basis, up to 1 month, all users of all our office can get the fix that was made for a particular customer. So the case study is about the Southeastern Health and Social Care Trust, which internally we call Ulster Hospital because it's shorter. So the one picture is the Ulster Hospital. It's an organization in Northern Ireland, in the UK, and they started a big migration project 2 years ago, and they started to migrate to our product, which was called Olapora GoOffice at the time, but now it's called Olapora Office. So they had a license agreement with Microsoft for Microsoft software, basically, but somehow Microsoft Office was not part of solution. So we not only provided them licenses for all of our office, but also offered them level 3 support package, which included bug fixes, and still the price was much lower than it would be with the Microsoft Office, which of course been without level 3 code support. So SS Collabora is a reputable company in the United Kingdom, and we have the most number of certified developers in the community, and we have experience in diversity support and so on. It we used the release for the migration. So first of all, we presented them the standard migration protocol, the strategy that the document foundation recommends, which means that we ask them to install Collabora Office on all workstations, do not segment the users as Microsoft users and normal users can work with Collabora Office, but we suggested to use Collabora Office parallelly with Microsoft Office from the first day. And of course, we also recommended to use the open document format. Unfortunately, they didn't take this advice, and they continued to work with proprietary Microsoft binary formats and OSL, because they said that it would have been impossible then to exchange documents with other trusts and other organizations who didn't use ODF. So this, of course, as you can expect, caused some problems in the migration, but here we have heard here some of the problems. About a year later, we wrote a case study about this migration process, which is a request at Collabora website, where we describe the technical problems that we met during this migration process. And basically, it's a success story. It was after 2 years of the pilot, Southeastern Health and Social Care Trust created a long report about the project, and basically what they wrote there, that migration is possible, at least 60% of the staff can migrate to Collabora Office, and the existing issues are minor and can be solved. During the pilot, they reported around 130 issues, and out of them, other side back in the day what things did. By the way, it's funny how users insert checkboxes in the documents. I saw a form that there's at least three types of checkboxes you can use for controls, context controls, or even they insert a special character which doesn't exist in the font, and then you get an empty rectangle. So I had a bug report just lately, and they inserted these things, and they wrote change this to something else because it's up to them. Another glyph instead of the empty box. So checkbox is empty. Then we had some problems with the ActiveX form controls. So we could import them, but they were not alive in the sense that we imported the EMF metafile picture instead of the picture control. Also, export was broken. Also, it was not similarly handled in Impress and Writer documents, but at the end, we solved all of those problems. So now, because the whole of our exposed, can export and import active controls. Another example, when the user just couldn't resize the table, then the edge was too close to the margin. It was a clearly effect that could be fixed easily, and the users were caring about. Another interesting example, when we evaluated the document, which was not from Microsoft Office, but from a third-party software, which used some deprecated OXML syntax, which was consumed by Microsoft Office, of course, but we had to implement this in LibreOffice too. So it shows the before and after screenshots show that finally we were able to import these validation drop-down cells. Tables. So when we got an email, when the subject is a table issue, we are, they said, because these problems happen very, very frequently. So the most annoying problem is that in Writer we don't have the concept of a floating table, while in Word it's quite common. So floating table means that a table floats around the page and the text can wrap around it, but unfortunately when you click on a table in Word and move the mouse only by one pixel, the table becomes a floating table. So we are using some heavy stick now in the code. Whether it's a real floating table or it's a normal table, which shouldn't really float. So the problem is that floating tables are usually imported in Writer sections, but those sections cannot span to multiple pages. So we have to use heuristics before we implement the floating table problem. Another problem with their weekly timesheets, which is quite important because employees want to get paid at the end of the month. So that the timesheets saved by LibreOffice were not consumed by the Visual Basic macro because the format was incorrect. So we had to use the BFF validator from Microsoft, which identified quite a few problems in our binary XLS export code. We solved all of these and job done. Another many problems than spare party tools produce broken OSL, which just not valid, basically. However, third can consume this, and the users don't care about the standards, they just care about the end result. So we had to implement Microsoft Word's behavior and accept invalid OXML files. Okay, so this one another floating table problem before and after the screenshots pretty much show the result of this bug fix, so we see nothing and then we have the table. That's great. Oh yeah, the merging empty cells confirmation dialog was a little bit confusion on their side, so it's a user experience problem. They didn't understand what was going on and asked us to change this message box that comes up when you want to merge cells in the car. Of course, another one with the crash is clearly a defect. We found the root cause of the crash and fixed it. Another interesting thing that some users like, they use their documents instead of. So they put documents into the documents, and those documents appear as an icon. So they just pull in files to the Word document and embed documents into the documents. Then the behavior was not clear in the office. So there are many combinations. You can have, for example, a binary doc, and you can embed XLS, SLSX, docx into this document. You can have the same with docx. And the behavior was all different in these cases. So we unified this behavior. Somewhat similarly what Microsoft Office is doing. So they also had problems with pivot tables, first of all performance problems, and second interoperability problems in Microsoft Excel. So it's still not fully finished, but we did a lot of work about pivot tables, both the performance and the standard compliance point of view. So one of the big advantages to have support from a company that it is possible to alter or suggest the ways where the project or the product evolves. So it's often asked question that where is the roadmap, what's on the roadmap, what we plan. Actually we implement features what the users like. And that if somebody wants to have influence on the roadmap, then need to ask for some consultancy work, and we are happy to develop features. So for example, the previously mentioned timesheet had yet another feature that the empty lines had to be deleted. On the other hand, they were protected. But those protection could not be over time should be filled in the office. They also wanted to disable some components of the office. For example, they didn't want the base UI, they didn't want PDF import, and I think in the beginning they didn't want the mod editor, but in the final version they had it dropped. And this switch was just about create these Microsoft installer transform files, which alters the MSI. So when they install the product, they have these options grayed out, and the user cannot accidentally start these applications. Another big topic in development task was the integration in SharePoint. So, unfortunately, replacing Microsoft software doesn't only mean replace Office, but there are components that we cannot replace, but we need to interoperate it. So one example is SharePoint and exporting SharePoint list to Bulk was solved during the course of this migration project. Another favorite feature request was the watermarks. They locked watermarks somehow, and it looked like an easy feature, and then we had a precursor of this feature in LibreOffice already. But at the end, it became a nightmare for us, because it turned out that the correct interoperability with Microsoft Office in terms of watermarks, it took really a lot of time. But by now, I think that the feature is complete and it's working perfectly for all five formats. And it's fully compatible with Microsoft Office. So in this Aster Hospital, there were users who used autotest heavily. Probably clinicians just typed in some radiation and it was expanding to this medical text. I don't know exactly, however, we had to solve the problem to import the autotext from the OSNL format, because only the binary form of import was present in the office before. The other big area where we developed a lot of things was the mail merge. So some mail merge mail merge, you need a database, the names and addresses and other stuff is there, and LibreOffice has plenty of options to store this data, but in Word, it was possible to use tables, simple tables in Word to use as a data source. But this feature wasn't present in Writer, and somehow the users liked this feature, and we had to implement it for them. The other problem with NeoMerge is that, as I mentioned, they don't use Open Document Format, they use Microsoft Document Formats. And there are quite a few problems in these formats in terms of NeoMerge. So, for example, mail merge fields weren't exported as such to Docker's formats. Also, they asked for some string of lines that have grant fields from the database. So it's a feature in Word, and they expect the same behavior. But we had countless other fixes, both on the user interface level and on the file format compatibility level that we had to do. Incidentally, these bugs were reported to Mozilla many years ago, but obviously nobody fix them, because these are not easy fixes. So it was important to have a paying customer who actually sponsored this work. This minor feature, highlight cross customization from Clark, was also asked by the hospital, because they said that if the these highlight colors cannot be customized, then colorblind customers can have problems. It make the distinction between those colors. So this was implemented. It was not a very big work, but it's a nice feature. I saw it in the presentation in this conference, and somebody found it interesting to mention. These Microsoft documents often contain macros written by the users, and they often ask how would the VBA.
You have just a couple of minutes.
Alright. Sure. So how would the VBA support in LibreOffice? The answer is it's pretty good, the VBA support, but who can guarantee that? You can run every and all of macros from Microsoft Office files. So it would be a huge task to implement everything, and it's not feasible. So our approach is that when we get a macro from a customer that has to be run, and we implement missing pieces that is from Spanish. So last year we implemented the format number function or the option button compatibility with the button, existing button class. We even met with Word Basic macros, which is a 20 years old deprecated technology, and we had to access basic macros. I'd like to mention colleague, also Thor, which is the presentation yesterday. So I just showed it. It is used for translating home calls from Visual Basic applications to collaborate office, which this way, CollaborOffice can be used as a drop-in replacement for Microsoft Office in some cases. It's very useful because sometimes these Visual Basic applications are crucial for the organization, but the source doesn't exist and it's not possible to replace it. Okay, I hurry up because I don't have much time left. We also fixed the proxy, automatic proxy detection on Windows, which is very important for getting the dash reports. And I just go through the other things that we have done, but I don't, unfortunately, I don't have time to talk about them. But the slides will be uploaded. So as a final word, exciting page, of course, because on one hand, everything we do is contributing back to the whole community and the users who use LibreOffice for free. But we shouldn't mention that everything we do is funded by our customers, and I would like to thank them